We have been very lucky because we have had my mum and dad come and stay with us in Dubai, and with their arrival has come lots of babysitting occasions. And one of these occasions, we went out for brunch at Beachcombers in the Jumeirah Beach Hotel. And we're ready for brunch.
Are you ready for brunch?
I'm ready.
Are you excited? First date night in a long time. It's only a night, it's a day, it's still a date.
So why did we pitch Beachcombers? Well, there were two reasons. First of all, it is just such good value for money. We always decided that we were going to go out for brunch because you just get a better package than you do going out for dinner. And the second reason is the beautiful views that it offers. You can sit out on the terrace, you look out to the ocean, and you've got the beautiful views of the Burj Al Arab. In terms of value for money, this brunch is around 500 dirhams, which is pretty much in line with all your good brunches in Dubai. So that gives you the drinks package with all you can drink and all you can eat. But what makes this more value for money is that it's actually in the entertainer. So it was 250 each, which actually is amazing to have all the food and all the alcohol that you can get. The type of food that you can expect is best described as pan-Asian, and I was actually quite surprised because with a name like Beachcombers, I wasn't expecting that sort of cuisine, maybe more international, more kind of casual, laid-back beach vibes. But you've got a massive sushi station to start with, a big salad buffet, you've got all your Thai favourites, there's amazing dim sum, there was an Indian station outside with about 6 or 7 different offerings, lots of Chinese choices as well, and there was also a roast dinner option, which I thought was a little bit random. I didn't get anything from there, but my husband did. And then you've got cheese and biscuits afterwards, and also a massive area of sweets, and there's even a children's section as well. So for my second reason, in terms of setting, I've always walked past Beachcombers and I thought that looks like a really nice spot to sit and have some lunch in the day. It's got a massive wraparound terrace, so a very large area for seating. And then I don't know if they have this area normally, but definitely for the brunch, they have lots of seating on the beach. If you wanted to have that seating on the beach, I would recommend you book in advance, because when we booked a week before, we could only get seating in the terrace area, which was still lovely, and obviously you've still got those beautiful views. In terms of entertainment, you've got live music, and then specifically for the children, you've got magicians, you've got balloon vendors and juggling clowns. There's also a separate room where the kids can play video games, and it's just really chilled. There's also a separate side buffet for the children, which I thought was really nice, and it had lots of healthy options as well. At about 3:30, these three guys came out, as you can see here, and did the most amazing acrobats. Now, I'm not sure if it was the alcohol or they generally were that good, but I remember running down from my table with my GoPro and standing there for the whole time that they were performing, for about an hour, just being in absolute awe of these guys. You can also see here in the background that there was a bouncy castle, and I'm not sure who liked this more, the kids jumping up and down having a great time, or the parents being able to relax for half an hour knowing that the kids were wearing themselves out. And then also another thing that I think was great for kids is that you've got this beach area, so there were actually goalposts behind, and I saw loads of kids kicking a football around and just running around having a great time on the beach. Now, the thing that I liked most about this brunch, I'm pretty sure it's something that you're not meant to do, so if you do do it, don't tell them that I told you so. But that is to take your drinks down onto the beach. So we did this twice. The first time was after our main course, and I was sufficiently stuffed at this point, but we took our drinks and we just walked down to the ocean, and we had a kind of like little paddle, and then we walked back, so we weren't away from our table for long. And then we came back into the restaurant and we ate more food, because obviously that's necessary when you're at brunch. You need to get sufficiently full, which definitely was the case. So then at the end of the brunch, I think there was probably about 45 minutes left, and we definitely had enough to eat. We topped up our drinks and we actually brought two drinks down with us, and we sat at one of the lounges on the beach and just sat there and chilled and just really had such a nice afternoon. I would actually describe this brunch as being perfect for children. It was hugely popular with families whilst we were there, although at the same time there were still lots of large groups, and obviously we were single couples and we really enjoyed the atmosphere too. I would say that the noise levels can get a little bit rowdy, especially once the kids have hit the chocolate fondue station. After brunch, because for some reason we felt like we needed more alcohol, we headed down to Shimmers, which has to be one of my favourite bars. You can just sit on the beach and enjoy more amazing views, and we had a few glasses of wine and a shisha to top off the perfect date brunch. And that's it. Thank you so much, guys. If you liked, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to watch more videos.